Beloved brothers and sisters in Christ, I am very glad to be with you this morning for the divine service, especially because it was unanticipated. Because of pastoral responsibilities yesterday, I found myself close to Cherry Hill, and I am happy to be with you, this wonderful community of St. Thomas, so close to the feast of Christmas. As the patriarchal vicar of this holy metropolis of New Jersey, it is a great joy to experience the life of this vibrant metropolis in person. In fact, today is the Sunday of the Forefathers. What is the Sunday of the Forefathers? It's the Sunday which falls on the nearest Sunday between December 11th and December 17th. It is the day on which we remember all the righteous figures from the Old Testament whose lives and character revealed, in a prophetic manner of course, revealed something of the mystery of the coming of the Christ, of the birth of Jesus Christ, the Messiah. The hymns today sing of the honored fathers of all ages past, from Adam, Abel, Seth, Noah, Enoch, Abraham, Melchizedek, Eov, Isaac, and Jacob, as well as the daughters of old, Hannah, Judith, Deborah, Huldah, and a lot of maids, and the sister of Moses, Rachel, Rebecca, and Ruth, the exceedingly wise. In every case, lives of these righteous men and women are a manifestation of the plan of God to save the world. The plan of God to save the world in the ecclesiastical and theological language is called economia. Ithia economia, the plan that God made after Adam and Eva left the paradise. God made a plan for us. He had to save us, to find an alternative, another way to save us. You see, our fathers didn't like paradise. They sinned and they were expelled from the paradise. And now God had to make a new plan. This new plan, with the birth of Jesus Christ, is called Thea Economia, Divine Economia. It is the story of God's outreach to the human family and His desire to include everyone in His household and in His kingdom. This is why today's Gospel reading is so important. There is something so very forceful about the command of the Ikodespoti, of the master of the state, when he learns from his servant that the summons to his banquet has been declined by those invited guests. So the Ikonomos, the master of the house, master of the state, commands, "Go out quickly to the streets and lanes, and bring in the poor, and the maimed, and the maimed, and the blind, and the lame." And when his servant replies, "My lord, what you commanded has been done, but there is still room," then the householder becomes more urgent and commands, saying, "Go out to the highways and the hedges, and compel people to come in, that my house may be filled." This insistence and real pressure is not a negative emotion for God. Rather, it is a sign of His love, the love for every single human being in this world of ours. Everyone, the billions of souls whom we will never know. So everyone, God wants them all in his table in the kingdom. When we hear of the poor and the maimed and the blind and the lame, we should understand these conditions as being those of the soul and heart, not of the body. There are people with a great deal of money in their pockets, but who are paupers in their souls. There are people who have been so hurt by the world and others in their lives that they cannot make their way to be loving. They cannot make their way to be decent and good. There are those who are blind to the truth about themselves, and therefore they cannot see the needs of others. And there are still others who have self-inflicted wounds, wounds of selfishness and greed that make it hard for them to reach out to others. But these are the very people that God wants, because he wants us all. My beloved Christians, this Christmas, let us be like the holy forefathers and foremothers whom we celebrate today. They sought to bring others to God, and we can do the same. Whether through a simple loving word, a phone call to someone we have ignored, or an invitation that is long overdue. Even as we continue to protect ourselves and others in this time of pandemic, we can still reach out and spread the message of God's inclusive and embracing love. Love in the world, in the little world that each of us inhabits daily. May the Lord, who is coming to be born in Bethlehem of Judea, grant unto us a blessed feast of his holy nativity, together with a safe, prosperous, and healthy New Year. Amen.